orange is my nemesis. I try to eat fruits, I buy them, and they sit in my fridge and rot, and then I throw them out. Rosemary Szabadka joins us, a registered dietitian with the Winnipeg Regional Health Authority, and the Canada's Food Guide is really, really pushing fruits and vegetables.
Yes, Canada's Food Guide, the new food guide that was launched, actually says that it's important to have, for an adult, 7 to 10 serving sizes of fruits and vegetables. And the reason why, I mean, just look at this table, Joanne. Mm. The color is so gorgeous.
Yeah.
I mean, who wouldn't want to come over here right now and just devour some of these foods? So really, what I want to talk about today is how much fun it is to eat fruits and vegetables and how we can incorporate our diet. And not only that, the nutrition in all these fruits and vegetables help lower chronic diseases such as cancers, diabetes, heart disease, and stroke.
It makes so much sense that it's natural. People have been eating it for millions of years.
Exactly.
This is what we need to get back to, what I know I need to get back to. And you've laid it out almost rainbow-like, starting
with dark
to light.
Yes, I wanted to talk about the purples to the greens to the reds, the oranges, the yellows, and the whites, just to concentrate on how important the color is. And also, a lot of the times, the colors will give a lot of the nutrients that people don't really know about.
Well, you always hear leafy greens.
Leafy greens. Leafy greens, broccoli. These are excellent sources of iron, folic acid, vitamin C, and also sometimes vitamin A as well. So excellent, excellent sources, these leafy greens. And if we talk about the oranges, such as carrots and yams and squashes, and I think I have some canned mangoes here, are also really good sources of vitamin A. Tomatoes too.
Well, I noticed when we were talking about color, my assumption was, okay, the mushroom, no color, does it offer anything? But it does.
It does. It has potassium, just like the banana over here, the friendly yellow banana.
Well, let's go back to the purples here.
Okay.
I mean, I love eggplant.
Right.
I love fruit.
Cabbage.
And you've got some ways here that we can get this fruit without having to actually sit there, chop it up, and eat it.
Right. Well, if you've got a blender at home, one really easy way to start off every morning, and I've made this for you, Joanne, is a blueberry banana smoothie.
Mm.
Very delicious, very easy. Bananas, I know you were telling me you don't like to peel things, but bananas
are very simple
to peel, and you just put it in the blender, and, you know, you just use some frozen blueberries, or you can use any frozen berries that you can get at the store. There's lots of these available now. You put in a handful, you put in some milk, soy beverage,
I know,
yogurt,
it's so
whatever you want, you just throw it in, and it's delicious, and you don't need any added sugars. And that's one thing that's beautiful about fruit. Because it has natural sugars, it is nature's way of sweetening the world.
There's so much I want to talk about that you've just touched on, quite a few things right there, and one of them I want to talk about is what's added to fruits when we use them in cans.
Okay.
Because I know for a lot of people it's so much easier to get the fruits and vegetables out of cans, but the tomatoes, like the salt in here, is what, 17%. Is that worth it?
Oh, definitely.
Okay.
Like, the thing is, it depends on what you eat generally in your diet. If you're staying away from lots of prepackaged foods, the sodium in here, yes, it is high, and I'm not disagreeing with that, but the time that you're going to have maybe this once or twice in the week will be fine.
Okay. So it will balance those.
So it's all about balance. Exactly.
Chopping.
And if you're in the summertime and you've got lots of ripe tomatoes on hand, it's a great way to make a sauce as well. In terms of mangoes, and I've got some sliced pineapple and peaches and pears, I mean, some of these are in light syrup, so you can certainly rinse those. A lot of them come in their own juice or even packed in water, and they're excellent sources of nutrients.
Because I see that some even add sugar, so you can just rinse that off.
Yes, you can rinse that. That's in a light syrup,
that particular one. Is juice better than syrup when you're looking on a can?
It would be better because it's natural, yeah,
okay.
And it doesn't have the added sugar.
Okay, so we've talked about cans. I want to talk about frozen vegetables,
mm-hmm.
because for me, frozen vegetables are great because you buy it, you use a portion, and then you can stick it back in the freezer. They're not going to rot.
Exactly. And one thing great about frozen vegetables is you can add it to soups and stews. You can add it very simply to a casserole. It's ready and on hand for anything that you want. And yeah, like this is only a half a cup of peas, right? So that is a portion size for you.
Much.
And that's not much.
Yeah.
This happens to be one cup, which is a portion size of leafy greens. So really, Joanne, just talking about you today, you're having your two servings of fruit here. If this is what you're having for supper tonight, that's another serving and another serving. So you're already up to four. Let's try to figure out
what I can do to get one more in.
Okay, what I do for my son, every time he comes home from school, he's kind of hungry, I chop some vegetables. This is considered about a cup, so that would be two servings for you. And he's getting a variety of different colors, and I always look at the colors, and that's a real appeal for children.
So can you chop them up for me too?
What you can do is, especially with certain things like carrots and celery, you can pre-chop them the night before, and then they're on hand. You don't want to pre-chop a lot of your peppers because the vitamin C will leave the pepper. But you know, yeah, like if it's pre-chopped for a long period of time, you would want to.
That's the kind of thing that I like to know. And chopping is fun with kids too, getting them involved and making them think vegetables.
Exactly, that's one thing. Get your child involved in the prep, and they'll eat it more.
What is there a fruit or vegetable that is the best for you? Like something you should be eating more of? Like I always thought, you know, the ones that you eat, Brussels sprouts and broccoli, are better for you than peppers.
Well,
is that true?
Broccoli is a wonder vegetable. Yeah. It's got basically everything in it. You can't beat broccoli in terms of the wonder vegetable. But really, Canada's Food Guide recommends one leafy green and one orange. And they're trying to say that if you eat those every day, then at least you'll be getting the nutrients you need. But go for the color, go for the variety, and go for the taste and the flavor.
And juice. That's important too, because I don't think I ever really seriously considered that juice that I was getting my fruits. I thought it was important to actually eat the pulpy, fibery stuff.
It is important to eat the pulpy, fibery stuff for sure, but a half a cup of juice, again, this is a serving size.
That's a
half a cup, and so it's not that hard again. So if you had that in between, but it is better to have the fruit because of the fiber. And when we think about Canada's Food Guide again, we're usually talking about small apples and small bananas in terms of a serving size.
So bottom line, for people like me who maybe I get enough vegetables, I know I do not get enough fruit. Bottom line, what is something you can tell our viewers to help them get those?
I would just keep a lot of frozen vegetables on hand. You can add them to even plain yogurt.
Right.
So, and then you can actually make a frozen yogurt just by adding frozen berries and stirring it around, and you've got kind of a frozen yogurt product. It's a great dessert. So again, to incorporate your fruits and vegetables in, let's say, a dessert product. A smoothie is a great way. Just having fruits and vegetables for you, that's easy to peel around the house. Grapes, strawberries, and keep them visible. In my house, everything is out. So when my son comes home from school, that's what he sees.
That's a very good tip as well.
If it's visible, he'll eat it.
Yeah, if it's tucked at the back of my fridge behind whatever, it'll be there for a month.
That's right. That's right.
So if people want more information about fruit, how much they should be eating, ways to get it, they can go to the
Dietitians of Canada website or Health Canada websites as well. We'll get lots of information and different resources.
Thanks so much
on eating fruits and vegetables.
Because it is Food Nutrition Month.
Yes, so Nutrition Month.
Nutrition Month. Perfect. Thank you very much.
Okay, you're welcome, Joanne.